And one of the most important things for stage is an aging makeup, actually, because there's two basic makeups for stage, important basic makeups. One is aging and one is a straight makeup. It's not any particular period or anything. It's just you looking as pretty as you and as handsome as you possibly can on stage, right? And stage makeup is normally done by the actors. Your job in theatre is mainly for the wig department. First of all, there's lots of different ways of doing this, but when I was first taught, I actually was taught that you do a base first, and then you do all the shading and highlighting, but then I realised that I was just using loads of makeup, and I was just doing the same thing over again, so I decided not to do it like that. So the first thing I do, and this is how I teach actors actually, because it's simple for them to know how to do it. This is 101, or it's a shader colour, which is a Kryolan, from a Kryolan grease paint palette. And grease is always used in theatre because it's waterproof. So if an actor's in a heavy costume and they're sweating, the perspiration sits on the surface of the makeup. And the thing I have to stress with using grease paint is, and the nice thing about it is, opposite to what people think about it, you don't actually need to use a lot of it. So I think of it as like when I'm paling down someone's face, I think of it almost like airbrushing the skin, you know, so you can still see a little bit of the skin underneath it. Ears, very important. Something about a boy's ears. Guys' ears tend to be much redder than girls, strangely enough. So you want to dampen those down, because when you get a light behind red ears, they sort of beam like beacons on stage, which is not what you want. Now, the next bit is to do the wrinkly bits, and I've gone back to the same colour, the shader colour, with a small eyeliner brush, and I'm just going to go in the dip where the eye. Actually, Steve hasn't got any bags under his eyes at all, so but everybody's got a little dip there, so that's where you put it. And then I'm going to do a couple of wrinkles at the top here. Now, I know some people sort of teach it like, you know, you raise your eyebrows and you see where everything's going, but sometimes I think that's not actually very helpful, because you end up with loads of little lines that look a bit like a crocodile, and you're not going to see it from a distance. So I tend to sort of keep my aging quite symmetrical. I think it's easier to read. As you get more experience, I think the main thing is that you get speedy, you know, you speed up the things. Because I remember having the luxury when you're a student, you've got ages to do it, haven't you? But actually in the real world, you know, you need that speed. Right, so now I'm going to blend the whole thing together. So I've got a clean sponge here. I quite like to use these for blending if I'm doing something fast. So just blend that in slightly. And the thing is with theatrical makeup, you know, you can do things like medium stage, big stage, small space. This is a kind of medium space, I guess. You probably need to make it bigger if it was a really big stage. If you go to an agency, don't do it unless you're absolutely convinced that it's better to go with two absolutely amazing pictures than a whole book full of mediocre work, you know. Better to go with two or three wicked things that you've spent a lot of time and effort sort of researching. Don't work with people unless you see their work, you know, like photographers. Don't, if you want to work in fashion, don't bother with a photo shoot unless there's a professional model doing it. Because honestly, you are wasting your time, because you, with fashion, you'll always get a really brilliant shot if the model is a good model, you know, a beautiful girl or a beautiful bloke. Your work should look the best it can be in the middle of the stalls, because that's where the critics sit and that's where the most expensive seating is. The back aren't going to see very much detail. They won't see any detail anyway. And the front row seats are not really considered the best seats.